we want a Do-more PLC to talk to a GS4 drive over Modbus TCP. For this video, we'll be using this network setup. You'll also need the GS4 drive's optional Modbus TCP COM card to communicate using Modbus TCP. To configure a Do-more enabled PLC for Modbus TCP, you just go to the system configuration and set up the IP address to be compatible with the network the GS4 drive is on, which in this example is this. There's a separate video showing how to configure the GS4 for Modbus TCP, and I've already done that. So all we need to do now is send commands. Let's have C10 do a Modbus write. We need the built-in Modbus TCP client, our GS4 drive is at this address, and we're writing to a single location. In Appendix B of the GS4 user manual, we see that Modbus TCP frequency commands need to be sent to address 8194. And since this chart uses the +1 addressing convention for decimal addresses, and that's exactly what the Do-more PLC expects, we put that here. The Do-more prepends the 4 for us. And let's set the frequency to 60 Hz. Let's copy and paste that rung and modify it so C11 changes the frequency to 45 Hz. Copy and paste that rung again, and let's have C12 run forward, which we know from that Appendix B table is done at this address and this binary value, which is this in hex. Copy and paste that again, and let's have C13 write to that same Modbus address, but set the bits to run in reverse. Copy and paste again, have C14 write to that same Modbus control address, but set the bits to stop the drive. And let's add an end. Let's give each of these control bits a name so they're easier to read in the data view. Great. Accept that, write it to the Do-more PLC. Let's bring up a data view and add those control bits. The drive is configured for Modbus TCP, and it's in remote mode, so it's ready to go. The PLC is running, so if we activate the 45 Hz instruction, sure enough, the drive changes frequency. If we activate the 60 Hz instruction, the drive reacts accordingly. If we toggle the run instruction, the motor starts turning, and we see that it's in the forward direction. Toggle the reverse contact, and the motor changes direction. And toggle the stop contact, and the motor ramps to a stop. Exactly what we expected. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.